Hello everyone, I'm Chen Zhang. Today I will introduce our work, Cocktail, Analyzing and Optimizing Dynamic Control Flow in Deep Learning. This is a joint work of Tsinghua University, Peking University, and Microsoft Research. In recent years, deep learning has shown its power in various domains like conversation, biological science, art generation, and recommendation. Control flow is everywhere in deep learning and is essential to express complex neural networks. One crucial application of control flow is using it to generate or analyze data with dynamic structures, such as sentences with variable length. Control flow is also used to dynamically select the layers to run at runtime, so the model can select the layers that are more relevant to the input and, and becomes more efficient. In deep learning, models are expressed by a sequence of parallelizable operators. For example, this model contains a parallel matrix multiplication, a parallel addition, and a parallel regular operation. These operators form the main computational workload in deep learning models. On the other hand, control flow operations are inherently sequential. Although they contain few computation, they can still significantly increase the execution time of a model. Existing approaches like PyTorch, TensorFlow, and JAX choose to execute the data flow operators on accelerators and control flow operations on CPUs. This is because data flow operators have good parallelism and aligns with the parallel architecture of the accelerators. But control flow are inherently sequential and with complex execution logic. So they cannot be efficiently run on accelerators and have to be run on CPU. This partition strategy can lead to large control flow overhead. In these figures, we compare trace graph, an ideal oracle that removes all control flow operations with the real case that executes the control flow operations at runtime. We can observe a significant slowdown on all three models. The large control flow overhead comes from the rigid partition strategy that runs control flow on CPU and data flow on accelerators. It leads to several problems. Firstly, there is frequent interaction between the CPU and the accelerator for exchanging data. It results in large synchronization overhead and prevents the CPU and the accelerator from running asynchronously, like they used to. Secondly, control flow operations split the entire computational graph to multiple smaller subgraphs. So the data flow optimizer can only optimize each individual subgraph, and many global optimization opportunities have been missed. To address the rigid partitioning issue of control flow and data flow, we propose Cocktail, a deep learning compiler that enables holistic optimization of control flow and data flow. Our design is based on two observations. Firstly, accelerators can execute the control flow instructions. This allows us to co-schedule both control flow and data flow into the accelerator side. Secondly, control flow in deep learning is cross-granted operator-level logic. The whole operator has the same control logic. Therefore, control flow may be efficiently executed on accelerators if they are properly scheduled. And it may not encounter issues like control flow divergency as executing general control flow on GPUs. To achieve the holistic optimization of control flow and data flow, we first need to enable the execution of both control flow and data flow on the accelerators. So we propose U-task, a unified abstraction for both of them. Additionally, modern accelerators are designed hierarchically and have multiple parallelization levels. We need to select the appropriate level for each control flow operation to make sure that they can execute efficiently. So we propose a bottom-up schedule policy. Firstly, I will talk about our U-task abstraction. we define U task as a compute logic of one compute unit on the accelerator. The logic includes both control flow and data flow. So we can optimize them holistically. And as we will see, this abstraction can represent the sequential control flow in a parallel manner. So we can schedule the sequential control flow to accelerators. Each data flow operator is naturally a set of parallel computational tasks, and is already implemented on the appropriate hierarchical level of the accelerator. Each task can be scheduled to arbitrary compute unit of that hierarchical level. And we can execute one task by calling it compute function. Control flow operations also use the same interface called compute. Each control flow U task consists of two parts, a function called named control flow, and the body U tasks that represent the U tasks managed by this control flow operation. The sequential control flow in the initial compute graph is represented by multiple U tasks now. For example, here is a loop over three operators named Met, Mo, Add, and Revu. We can schedule it to four parallel U tasks. Each U task contains the loop as a control flow and a sequence of U tasks as body U tasks. And each U task represents the compute logic of one compute unit. Note that each control flow U task is still a U task. So the body U tasks can contain control flow operation. And therefore, we can support the nested control flow operations. The control flow of the U task can be pinned to arbitrary hierarchical level of the accelerator. And we need to perform a scheduling to find the proper hierarchical level. I'll talk about it later. The U-task abstraction is general for various control structures. Currently, our cocktail system supports loop, branch, and function call, the three most widely used operations. They are all implemented with a control flow function and a series of body U-tasks. And we also support recursion as a special form of function call. You can see our paper for more details of this control flow type. Here is an overview of our cocktail system. Its input is a compute graph exported by existing deep learning frameworks. For example, export an OSDI graph from a PyTorch program. We first use a program translator to translate the data flow operations into parallel U tasks and keep the control flow unchanged. Then, we use a holistic optimizer to coordinate the scheduling of data flow and control flow. And we have integrated several optimization methods for both control flow and data flow. The holistic optimizer can generate a whole program represented in U tasks. And this program can be efficiently executed on accelerators. Cocktail now supports NVIDIA GPU and AMD GPU, and may be extended to other architectures in the future. I will explain more about the holistic optimizer now. The main component of the holistic optimizer is the co-scheduler for data flow and control flow. It will find an efficient scheme to execute the program. The scheme needs to specify the hierarchical level for each control flow operation and the execution plan of other data flow operations. For example, we now want to schedule a nested loop to an accelerator with two hierarchical levels. So one is a compute unit level, and the other is the accelerator level. We use a bottom-up traversal to achieve this. The algorithm starts by scheduling the lowest level operations and distributes them across different parallel units of the accelerator. Each compute unit is responsible for a subset of U tasks. Next, we add control flow logic to the scheduled program. Here, we use profiling to decide the hierarchical level that makes the control flow operations most efficient. For example, in this case, we choose to schedule the control flow on the compute unit level instead of the accelerator level. Then we move on to the level with a loop and a matmul operator. As the loop has the same interface with data flow operations, we can schedule it as a normal U task, so that we can co-schedule the U tasks of the loop and the U tasks of the matmul and generate the execution plan in the right figure. Finally, we schedule the outmost control flow operation. We select the accelerator level instead of the compute unit level based on profiling. We now finish the scheduling of the entire program. The inner loop is scheduled to the compute unit level, and the outer loop is scheduled to the accelerator level. And other data flow operations are also assigned to the proper compute units. We also perform some optimizations during scheduling. As for general control flow optimizations, as the loop unrolling, we can seamlessly integrate them and may make them more powerful in some cases. We have also proposed some interesting optimizations for specific type of control flow, like branch and recursion structures. You can read our paper if you are interested in them. We conduct our experiment on NVIDIA V100 GPU and AMD MI100 GPU. Due to time constraints, we will only present the results on V100. We select 7 representative models that covers common control flow types, such as branch, loop, function calls, and recursion. We compare with 4 baselines, including 3 popular deep learning systems, PyTorch, TensorFlow, and JAX, plus a cocktail base that uses the same code base with cocktail, but executes the control flow on CPU. On average, cocktail is 5 times faster than PyTorch, 22 times faster than TensorFlow, 4 times than JAX with JIT enabled, and nearly 5 times over cocktail base. Next, let's take a closer look at the control flow overhead. In JAX, control flow overhead on average slows down the models by 188%, while in cocktail, the control flow overhead only slows down the model by 16%, reducing the control flow overhead by a factor of 10. This indicates that cocktail can significantly reduce the control flow overhead. In summary, our cocktail system is a deep learning compiler that has been specifically designed for optimizing dynamic models with control flow. It can perform holistic optimization of control flow and data flow, and achieves up to 8.2 times speedup over state-of-the-art systems. And the code has been open sourced. Thanks for your listening, and looking forward to questions in Q&A. Thank you very much.